Welcome to episode 1 of Patch's SNES Playthrough. Today we will discuss 2020 Super Baseball, Three Ninjas, Kickback, The Seventh Saga, and finally, A.S.P, Airstrike Patrol. So our first game, 2020 Super Baseball, I did a one-player league and I chose the Ninja Black Sox. Just cutting into a couple areas where I actually hit the ball, base is loaded here, and I get a single. Basically, it's typically like your normal baseball game, except every action you do will give you more or less money, depending upon if it was good or bad. And the money is actually spent to do some pretty interesting things, which I will show coming up. You have human players and robot players. Robot players will actually break down, and human players will tire. So I finish off that particular inning with 2, and the other team had 2 for that inning as well. So you can do a pinch hitter at any time. And I chose to bring in the robot because the power is just incredible. And I will get a strike and an out. Fantastic. So it was totally worth bringing in the pinch hitter. So you see here, I switched over to the other team hitting because they did something I didn't know how to do at the time. And he pulls up the team power-up. Now, the money you earn is spent on powering up your players. So he has hitting arm C, and I decide, well, I'm going to hit him with a header ball, because I don't want to see what happens. So he does it again, and you have to put it on the particular player, power up 40%, and she bunts with higher power. And I completely mess up catching it. Once again. So I get a double play here. Out and out with a changeup. So now we're back or onto our next game, which is Three Ninjas Kickback. I play as Colt. It's just a platformer. I mean, pretty standard for the time, especially with a movie license game. And it's one of those ones where, you know, I'm doing everything by trial and error. I have no idea what the controls are and what the limitations are, that kind of stuff. Apparently the big rocket kills you in one hit. So I fall, get hit by the rock. It's one of those things like I have to learn the game before I can actually do anything good. And it took me a little bit, but I got used to it. I think if I gave it more time, it would actually be pretty fun. You know, I'd like to give it some credit for what it is. It's just a little run around, gather points fest. And you fight an old man in rocks, at least for the first couple of stages here. Stupid shuriken throwing things. So, with level 1 complete, I walk on to the next game. This game is the Seventh Saga. It's an RPG, like a classic one, and all turn-based fighting, that kind of stuff. You know, walk around, talk to villagers, start with no inventory, some money maybe, and have to buy the items you need. Skip over the story, because nobody cares about that. Well, maybe some people do, but at the moment, I'm just trying to express how the game plays. So you have a choice of characters. I picked Alien last time. I'm going to pick Alien again because it's cool, but I wanted to look at the differences and what they have and things like that. So I am debating this time. I'm playing a Tatujin because he has better defense and everything. But go with the alien. Name him Ass. 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 The alien warrior. So I'm walking around the village, blah, 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 blah. One button kind of does everything. So I search, and there are many jars. Fantastic. So I bought some potions and went out to the field of battle. And it's turn-based, classic. You know, you punch as this guy. He can't actually equip any weapons whatsoever, or to my knowledge, and no armor as well. So I'm not really sure what the benefit is, but I'm sure it would become apparent as I played the game more. So with the battle won, I get experience and gold, and continue to walk on to the next game. And this one's kind of fun, actually. it's similar to Desert Strike and stuff, but you fly planes. There's a large planning segment before the stages actually start, which I skipped over because it's boring and mildly confusing without knowing what every little thing does. You can pick different planes. There was three to choose from, two different F-15s and the A-10 Warthog, which I chose last time I played, but for this recording, because it moves faster and frankly, it flew a heck of a lot better in the situations, I decided to use the F-15. You got your ground attacks, and you have to use them sparingly because, you know, you gotta destroy specific things in the level. And if you run out of ground missiles, well, then you're kind of boned. The fun part about it, though, is the actual dogfights, which now when the warning thing comes up, my little radar in the top left there changes, and it's trying to point me towards the incoming plane. And for that, you use, obviously, your, you know, chain guns and things like that. And here we go, dogfight time! You know, slowing down, obviously, to be able to be more maneuverable in the situation helps a lot. I missed my shooting my chaff off to divert that incoming surface-to-air missile. But I get this guy pretty good. I get behind him and, you know, shoot him down right out of the sky. Kaboom! So I cut it again to the next segment where I get another dogfight. And then I'm gonna let it run out of time here because I don't know how to refuel or restock or any of that stuff, and I guess that's part of the fun of it, is the time limit that you have to actually complete your objectives. And I was mostly just flying around trying to figure everything out. So it actually, you know, it's one of those things, like, you have to give it a little bit of time, and I gave it less credit than I wanted to the first time, because I was just trying to compare it to Desert Strike, but as a plane flying game, it's actually not too bad. I mean, for the time, on a Super Nintendo, graphics aren't too horrible. I think that's one of those things that, like, I look back in, you know, a little bit jaded perspective because of what we have now. But it is pretty fun for what it was, and I like it a lot, actually. I think I'd give this one another play. And I pulled up the menu trying to find where some more of the radar dishes are, because I wanted to try and destroy some of them before I, you know, run out of fuel and crash to the ground. Because that was the mission's goal for this one, to destroy 80% of all the radars in the area. Or radar installations. Nice look at that plane on me. So I decided to afterburner the heck out of there before I crash and burn, just like the end of this episode.